Simani, welcome back to my channel, and today I'll be talking about fragrances. So in today's video, I'll be sharing with you my top 3 favorite fragrances of all times. Now, I personally love wearing perfumes. I think it makes you so attractive, it makes you unforgettable, and it also enhances your style. It automatically shows people, tells people who you are, even before you start speaking. But this doesn't mean that I'm a fragrance expert. No, I'm not a fragrance expert, so I'll not be talking about those top notes, base notes, and all of that stuff. I'll just be sharing my thoughts about what I like, what I feel about these fragrances. So I've picked 3 of my favorite perfumes, one of which I think is ideal for daytime, one for nighttime, and one for all times. But before getting on with the video, please hit the subscribe button if you haven't already, and if you have, hit the bell button so that you get notified every time I upload a new video. So without further ado, let's start. So the first fragrance that I'll be talking about today is my favorite daytime fragrance for summers, and it's Light Blue by Dolce & Gabbana. Now, this perfume has been out since so many years, and it's not for no reason that it's been one of the best-selling female fragrances in this world. Now, whenever I smell it, oh my god. It's very light, crisp, fresh, very citrusy, and I think it's perfect for summers. I think it's a perfect blend of fresh, floral, and fruity. So if you have to buy just one fragrance for summertime, I think it has to be this one. The next perfume that I'm going to be talking about is, according to me, ideal for nighttime. And it is Black Opium by Yves Saint Laurent. I don't know if I said it correctly. It's Yves Saint Laurent. Whatever. It's YSL. So Black Opium by YSL. Now you must be thinking that if I love this perfume so much, why do I have such a small bottle? So here's the thing. Now I had heard and read a lot of mixed reviews about this one, so I was quite reluctant to splurge in a full-size bottle. Because fragrances like this are not cheap, they are very expensive. But since it's described as a coffee and vanilla scent, I had to give it a try. Because I am like literally obsessed with these two things. So I thought I'll try a travel size small bottle first and see if I really like it or not. And now after using it for quite some time, I can say that I completely adore this fragrance. It's very sexy, sweet coffee with florals in the background. Now when I tried this perfume for the first time, I realized that for the first 5 minutes, it really smells like white flowers. But after about half an hour, it dries down to more of a warm, oriental, spicy scent. And it's because of that reason I feel that it's quite appropriate for nighttime. It's very strong, sexy, and glam. And the best part is it lasts for a really long time. It lasts for about 8 to 10 hours minimum. Now the third and the last perfume I'll be talking about is the one that I feel is appropriate for all times. And that is Viva La Juicy Gold Couture. Now just like the bottle and the packaging, it's a gorgeous, very feminine fragrance. When you smell it for the first time, you feel it smells very edible because it's got caramel, berries, and vanilla. Now this I would say is not the most long-lasting fragrance. It lasts for only about 5 to 6 hours, but it is definitely a day, night, clubbing, date night, all around fragrance, so it's definitely worth buying. So that was all for today's video. Do let me know if you like any of these fragrances or if you personally use any of them. And if not, then what are the fragrances you like and you use? I would definitely like to try all the perfumes out there. Thank you so much for watching. Please do not forget to hit the subscribe button, bell button, like, share, comment, whatever you can do. You know the drill. And I'll see you next week with a brand new video. Till then, bye-bye.